made me glad. Jesus has made me glad. Enter his courts with thanksgiving in your heart, for he has made me glad.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Jai Yesu ki. Today we remember and celebrate the feast of Our Lady of Mount Carmel. So happy feast to all of you. In a very special way, a happy feast to all the Carmelites. It was mentioned in the scriptures where Prophet Elijah lived on Mount Carmel. So very associated with, very much onto the life of the Jewish community. And then from the 12th century, some of the hermits started staying there, and then the Carmelite making Our Lady as the patron of their hermitage and becomes the Carmelite order from the 12th century. So to say, the protection that Mother Mary gives to the people of the God has been entrusted and experienced today in a very special way. And we also know the scapular Mother Mary given to Simon Stock, one of the superior generals of the congregation, is also very popular among most Christians. People believe, as Mary's promise, wearing a scapular and dying would not lead you into eternal condemnation. Let's pray through the intercession of Blessed Mother today for each of us and for all those who are struggling, especially people who miss their mothers in their lives. Very special way we pray and go to God and thank God for the gift of good results to all the Notre Dame schools in a very special way for here in Najafgarh. So we thank God by offering this Mass as a thanksgiving sacrifice. So as we come together this morning, my dear brothers and sisters, let us examine ourselves and ask Lord to forgive those moments when we have gone away from His love. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe
eleison. Kyrie eleison. Let us pray. May the venerable intercession of the glorious Virgin Mary come to our aid, we pray, O Lord, so that fortified by her protection, we may reach the mountain which is Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
The first reading is taken from the prophet Isaiah. The path of the upright man is straight. You smooth the way of the upright. Following the path of your judgments, we hoped in you, Lord. Your name, your memory are all my soul desires. At night my soul longs for you, and my spirit in me seeks for you. When your judgments appear on earth, the inhabitants of the world learn the meaning of integrity. Lord, you are giving us peace since you treat us as our deeds deserve. Distressed, we search for you, Lord. The misery of oppression was your punishment for us. As a woman with a child near her time, writhes and cries out in her pains, So are we, O Lord, in your presence. We have conceived, we wreathe, as if we were giving birth. We have not given the spirit of salvation to the earth. No more inhabitants of the world are born. Your dead will come to life, their corpses will rise. Awake, exult, all you who lie in the dust. For your dew is a radiant dew, and the land of ghosts will give birth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm response. The Lord looked down from heaven to the earth.
The Lord looked down from heaven to the earth.
You, O Lord, will endure forever, and your name from age to age. You will arise and have mercy on Zion, for this is the time to have mercy. For your servants love her, very stones are moved with pity, even for her dust. Response. The Lord looked down from heaven to the earth. The nations shall fear the name of the Lord, and all the earth's kings your glory. When the Lord shall build up Zion again and appear in all his glory, then he will turn to the prayers of the helpless. He will not despise their prayers. Response. The Lord looked down from heaven to the earth. Let this be written for ages to come, that a people yet unborn may praise the Lord. For the Lord leaned down from his sanctuary on high. He looked down from heaven to the earth, that he might hear the groans of the prisoners and free those condemned to die. Response. The Lord looked down from heaven to the earth. Gospel acclamation.
Nations, praise the Savior endlessly, as he for his love. Alleluia,
alleluia,
alleluia, alleluia,
alleluia,
alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew. Jesus exclaimed, "Come to me, all who you labor and are overburdened, and I will give you rest. Shoulder my yoke and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. And you will find rest for your souls. Yes, my yoke is easy and my burden is light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of the Gospel wipe away your sins and offenses. My brothers and sisters, today the invitation from the Lord is to share his yoke and share his burden. The thing is, the primary principle in this is, it only happens when each of us realize that you are laboring and you are overburdened. Unless and until we have this experience of that I am burdened, I'm heavy, this shouldering the yoke of the Lord would not be possible. Today what is happening in our current situation is man with his innovations, creativity and intelligence think 99% of things of his could be handled by himself, because the money power that all of us have, we think money can buy everything. Since money was the primary priority in each one's life, and even despite this corona issue, it is the same. How I realize that I need an external support to carry forth in my life? If fully each of us realize that I need an external support to carry forth with my life, I cannot share or I cannot take this burden with the resources that are available with me on earth, then only we will put our complete trust in the Lord. Every difficulty that all of us go through, we think we can buy with money, but not everything. The burden that when we realize that I am overburdened, I am under a lot of labor, we need to see God. And Jesus is ready, waiting there. We are actually reluctant to share a burden with Him. I normally say, my personal experiences, I would say, whenever difficult times, I say, it is yours, I cannot do it, and I move away. And I know how smoothly the Lord takes care of such things. So today we pray on the feast of Mary, Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Let's throw ourselves completely under the feet of the Lord. Let Him take care of ourselves, our lives. We say to Him, a lot of prayers are going away up to the heavens for Corona. Let's say, Lord, this is the burden on us. Please share this burden with us. And He'll take care. And that's faith. God bless you.
Under the table you set, yours as we eat the bread, ours can bless the Lord God of all creation, for the goodness of this bread.
We are the signs of your life, we are yours. We are yours. We are yours.
By the mercy of the God of all creation, for the goodness of wine to offer, for the wine of the Spirit is one to offer. Lord, we ask for this.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
As we honor the memory of the mother of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of the sacrifice may, by your grace, make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary of the Mount Carmel, to proclaim your goodness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. Truly, even to the earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us her, through her, the author of salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to His second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognize in the sacrificial victim by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with His Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May He make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, and with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Francis of Assisi, John Mary Vianney, St. Julie, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity, Pilgrim Church on Earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, Anil, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of the family whom you summoned before you. In your compassion, a merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed parents, brothers and sisters, friends and well-wishers, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom that we hope to enjoy forever the vision of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through Him and with Him and in Him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on us sins, but on the faith of the church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, forgive
us
the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, forgive us the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Mother body and of Lord Jesus Christ, pray to the strength of our mercy and contemplation. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. With the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep us safe for eternal life. Let us do the spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things. I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of grace and experience its continued increase of our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go in the love of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the intentions of the Archdiocese of Delhi, of your congregations, for your families, for the whole world, in a special way for all the Carmelites, we pray. Remember the most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who applied your protection, implore your help and sought intercession, was left in need, inspired this confidence. Fly unto you, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To you I come, before you I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of Word Incarnate, despise not my petitions, but in your mercy hear and answer me. May your mother queen of peace and channel of all grace. So thank you very much for celebrating this mass with me today. God bless you. Have a great day.
Call eternally that He could give.